Mohini's Beauty Hut, and with Anupriti Govind Sharma doing the photo shoot for Fashion Herald. Hi Anupriti, kaise ho?
I'm very nice, thank you so much Abhishek. First of all, I would like to thank you for having me on the show.
You're welcome. Tell me Anupriti, what's your purpose of visit to Lucknow this time?
Lucknow is my hometown, by the way, this is for everyone to know, and I keep coming to Lucknow a lot of times for a lot of shoots and assignments, but this time especially I'm here for a very special collaboration with Mohini's Beauty Hut for a bridal beauty photo shoot, since the bridal season is already upcoming in Lucknow. So we decided to collaborate and have a special beauty shoot especially for the brides this season in Lucknow, and that's the purpose of my visit.
Tell me one thing that you are starting. I have heard a web series on YouTube. So I just wanted to know what's the importance of social media in an actor's life?
Yes, you have heard it right. Recently, I have started my own production house by the name of Anupriti Govind Sharma Productions. And the reason why I have begun this campaign on social media is because about 5 years ago, I did not know what social media was or what its importance was. I did not know what YouTube is or what a Facebook page looks like or how to create one. I probably did not know much more than all of you know right now, and you guys might know much more than what I know. So the purpose of starting this campaign was to make an eye-opener campaign for fellow actors and artists who are learning the nuances of their crafts. And they should know that there is a platform available in the name of social media which they can utilize to their advantage in the development of their career. So when I chose social media, what I saw in it, which many people miss, is that these are communication lines, Abhishek. These are massive communication lines which cost nothing for you and I to literally build a brand image and impression in the marketplace as an artist. It is a platform which literally costs nothing to fellow actors to sell their talent in the marketplace, in their associated industries, so that people from the industry can get a glimpse into their craft, into their talents, so that later on these artists can be approached for commercial assignments as well. So Abhishek, social media is literally a way to become a celebrity in your own space. When I came to social media, I already had my frustrations with traditional TV and radio. And because of my own frustrations and disappointments, what I saw in social media was a platform which allowed me to take charge of my own career, which allowed me to take control of my brand image, my reputation, and the message that I was sending out to the audience. And most importantly, the frequency at which I was sending out that message to the audience. Social media allowed me to control my image, my reputation, my branding as an actor, and the frequency with which I could communicate to my audience. So the first thing I did was to make a commitment to myself. When you use social media, you don't just want to use it, you literally want to abuse it. Don't get me wrong, I'm just trying to over-exaggerate my situation to make a point here. The point is, when you have social media at your disposal, what you need to do is to take that line of communication and use it as often as you want to use. Something which movies or traditional media, traditional TV do not allow you to do as an actor. You can control the frequency of your message, control the frequency of your films, your videos on YouTube and social media as much as you want to build your own image. Look, you and I will not be invited to national news channels over and over every day to brand ourselves or to advertise our talent. We will not be invited to national news channels. And that's where the power of social media comes in. It's a very powerful mechanism to reach to millions and millions of people every day, worldwide, to make your talent known to everyone.
So, Anupriti, tell me, how can an actor grow effectively on a social media?
The most simple answer is to start. Simply start and start fast. All you have to do is create an account and start posting good, meaningful and value-added content. That's the first and the most simplest step that any actor can take. The second step, Abhishek, is to post often and keep posting. There is no such thing as posting too much. There are a lot of experts who claim on social media that posting too frequently is a bad thing, because they feel if we post too much on social media, people will quit following us. But the truth of the matter is, in the beginning, when any actor is starting, or any artist is starting for that matter, they don't have any followers to begin with. So the only way to grab attention for their talent is by posting frequently and posting regularly, at the same time making sure that what you're posting is good and value added, has quality to it. So keep posting as much as you can, as much as your internet connection allows. There is no such thing as posting too much. And the people who quit following you in the long run are the people who aren't actually your market in the beginning. And they will not be the potential buyers of your talent in the long run. So please don't worry about them. The third is, you have to become the celebrity in your own space, Abhishek. We need to make sure that our content is quality oriented so that you can be the best in what you do. It can be comedy, action, romance, thriller, horror, whatever you want to work on as an actor, make sure that you keep striving to be the best at it so that there is no competition for you. The fourth step is to make the entire planet Earth your target audience. Traditional TV will not allow an actor to target every nation or every continent and the audience from all continents. But internet, or as we say World Wide Web, allows us to post content which is visible to anyone across the earth. That is one advantage which internet has over traditional media and television. So keep posting quality content and make sure that when you are posting, somebody on the other side of the earth is probably watching your video and getting inspired to take the next step, which could probably be hiring you for their next assignment. I follow, and I will urge my fellow actors to follow, is what I personally call the 80-20 rule, which means that 80% of the content which you post on social media and Facebook should be entertainment based. It should provide quality entertainment to your audience, and 20% of your content should be promotional based, because you need to promote your videos as well. But do not decrease the percentage of your entertainment to increase the percentage of your promotion. Because in the beginning, all you want is followers. You need subscribers, viewers as well. So you need to post as much entertainment-based content as possible so that you can build your followership. Once you have a lot of followership, you can increase the percentage of your promotional values. This is one mistake which most of the actors do. They focus more on promotions and they post less content which is based on entertainment or information. Do not make that mistake. And the last rule which I follow and I urge everyone to follow is, do not delegate your promotions and your social media. No matter how important your position or how busy your schedule, make sure that the voice is yours. You are behind your social media. For that matter, I also have a very big marketing team which takes which takes care of my social media promotions. But I always make sure that the voice is mine. No matter how social media savvy my team may be, but at the end of the day, I'm the person who knows my craft the most. So only I will be able to provide authentic information on my YouTube channels and my Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat. My team is there to promote my videos, promote my content, but the content has to come from you, just the way it comes from me. So be authentic to your channels.
Okay, Nikhil, now tell me specifically about YouTube. How can just YouTube be important in a career of an actor?
Yes, definitely. I would love to speak about YouTube. YouTube, for me personally, has been one of the greatest experiences of my life. When I started my own productions, Anukriti Govind Sharma Productions, I also wanted to create a platform that was fun, that was exciting, and at the same time allowed me to connect with an audience in ways that my movies did not allow me to connect. I'm sure you can understand. I have a team which runs my channel, but the content comes from me, and there are interactive sessions and there are Q&As with my audience, where my audience send me questions and queries about what they want to know about my work or my lifestyle or, you know, my hobbies, my passions that I follow apart from my films and work. So YouTube has allowed me to enter into a more personal space with my audience. Because movies don't allow an actor to do that. There is always a space, a distance between us and our audience. YouTube bridges that gap. I believe that is one of the most important benefits of YouTube in an actor's career. Because the audience gains a more personal perspective into an actor's life, which increases the likability or the relatability of an actor with their audience. When the audience sees an actor, a celebrity who is so inaccessible, living a life like theirs, having feelings and emotions just like them. There is a connection, there is an emotional connection which builds with the celebrity. And that's where the connection between the audience and the celebrity comes in. YouTube, I personally believe, helps tremendously in that regard. Another advantage is being your own boss. You don't have to wait for a movie or a TV script to come knocking your door. You don't have to wait for a producer's call to give you a job. You have like-minded people working with you, and all you have to do is create your own content the way you like it and post it as frequently as you want to post it on YouTube. So creative freedom is another advantage which YouTube offers to an actor. Likeability, personal connection with the audience, creative freedom, not depending on a producer or a director to come and make a film or a video for you, taking charge of your own career, taking charge of your own videos, posting them the way you like it. There are no headaches involved like taking permissions from a film chamber or taking a permission from a lobby to release a film. Internet does not have those hassles. All you have to do is just create an account, sign into your account and upload a video as and when you wish. So YouTube offers that creative freedom to you. So why not make complete use of it?
So Aradi, tell me, how come Facebook and YouTube be used by people like businessmen and real estates and such people who are doing their business in the education sector?
Yes.
Tell me that.
Oh yes, that's a very useful question, Abhishek. I would definitely like to throw some light on that. Let's take today's example, for instance. We are sitting at Mohini's Beauty Hut, and the owner of the salon, Mohini Gupta, and along with Fashion Herald, both of these companies have been very kind and cooperative with my production house to collaborate, join hands in creating a bridal beauty shoot and a video along with it. They have been very cooperative with my production house to come together and dedicate this day to building nice content for YouTube, wherein Mohini's Beauty Hut also benefits from the video, Fashion Herald also benefits, as well as my production house. So what we see is a team of like-minded people coming together to create great content. This happened today. Now yes, definitely this has an artistic angle to it because we have a bridal makeup guru working with us, Mohini Gupta. The second example which I would like to give is Pooja Sarees. I recently did a beauty campaign and a designer campaign with Pooja Sarees, which is a bridal couture brand based out of Hyderabad. So what we did was, my production house got in touch with the owner of Pooja Sarees, who is Mr. Rama Agarwal. And again, it was a collaboration of like-minded artists coming together to create great content, which has turned out to be very beneficial and useful for the team of Pooja Sarees, as well as my team. Coming to, like you said, the so-called non-artistic sectors where artists' creativity or involvement is not involved. For example, businessmen or corporate houses or educational institutions. I would like to throw light on this, Abhishek, by saying that my coming projects are based on a series of documentaries which focus on severe social issues, and we are trying to send out useful social messages to the media, to the people, to our people, our audience who watches our videos. For that, we are already in talks with a series of higher educational authorities who are going to collaborate with us in creating documentaries on subjects like girl education. We see that girls are still underprivileged in our society and education is not so accessible. This is one example which I am quoting. So that is one very serious issue which I am working on along with my team, and we are trying to collaborate with universities and higher educational institutions so that we can come together on a single platform and create good, meaningful content which can send across a very strong social message to support the girl, child and her education. Similarly, coming to businessmen involved in the real estate, we have videos and a series of short films coming out where there is an innate requirement of amazing infrastructure, both outdoors and indoors. Real estate companies come into the picture at that time. We need infrastructure because the infrastructure is demanded by the scriptwriters who are writing our scripts right now. That's where my production team is getting in touch with the real estate builders and owners of big real estate companies, wherein again we can collaborate on an artistic level and a technical level so that their infrastructure can be made use of completely in our films, and at the same time our films can be a useful medium for the companies, the real estate companies, to brand and advertise their infrastructure through our films. Our films offer them a platform for their promotion and their advertising, and at the same time, their infrastructure and their property adds production value to our films. So these are certain ways in which businessmen and educational authorities get in touch with us and collaborate with us to create mutually benefiting videos for YouTube. So these are the ways in which our company and real estate companies and higher educational authorities can collaborate with us on a single platform to create films and documentaries which can be mutually benefiting for all the industries involved.